Welcome back to another video. I hope you're doing well. I'm quitting Honkai Star Rail, and yes, I'm really quitting it. I know it's a meme in the content creation space to say that you're quitting a game, but I'm very good at quitting things, so when I say I'm quitting, I'm truly quitting. But yeah, TLDR, I've played the game every day since the release as a free-to-play, and I've just hit the point where there's really not much to do in the game anymore. I have over 300 hours, which is insane for a mobile game. I've been able to pretty much do every piece of content the game has to offer, and now it's just the basic gambling simulator for me, so I think I'm gonna start looking for a new mobile game or just move on to other games. Even though it's a pretty low maintenance game, but it still does require weekly quite a few hours to play, and I'm just kind of bored of it now, so I think it's time to sunset the game. I thought it would be fun to do like a final video, just go through my progression, and it's a quite nice ending point to see my 1 year free to play progression so far. So you kind of know what to expect to get in a year. Well, I think first we can go through all my pulls. I think my account is pretty cracked for a free-to-play account, so I'm actually pretty happy. I did get quite lucky with my rolls, so it's been a pretty good run. So obviously we had the first. I got Young King from that. Then this is my Stellar Warps. I mean, it's a pretty lucky to get Bailu and then get two Bronias at the same time. Like, I guess it's a bit sad that I got two of the Bailu Light Cones, but this was pretty good, I would say. Quite lucky here. I haven't rolled any light cones because I don't think as a free-to-play it's a bit difficult to roll light cones. But then we get to the special banners, so yeah, when it comes to the banner, I'm sitting around 50% win rate on the 50-50s, which seems to be pretty high. Pretty happy with that. We nearly hit 1,000 warps. Not quite there yet, but we're pretty close. And especially now towards the end, I've been hitting some really lucky streaks. I did get E1 Dunhang, which was not that good, but that was kind of an accident. I didn't mean to do that. But yeah, so far, I feel like I got pretty lucky. I guess Ruan Mei would be one character I don't have. That would be pretty good for my comps. But yeah, it's been pretty good. Here we go with the characters. First, we have Phuc Xuan, which is pretty built. She has nearly maxed out traces. I was kind of building this. I don't have a very good light cone for her. I have to use this one. It's okay. And then relics are just kind of a somewhat okay. Nothing too special. Then my sparkle is pretty much maxed out on the traces. Light cone, I don't have a good light cone for her at all. So I'm just using the meshing cogs for her. Then we got my Dunhang, which is his build okay. Nothing too special. Got the double crit rate on him, which is pretty nice. Fully maxed out traces and pretty much a rainbow set because, you know, why not? We do like a rainbow set here. Ting Young, pretty basic. I haven't fully built her yet. I probably have enough materials to build her, but so far haven't done that. I got my Bailu pretty much built up. Got her light cone here. And oh, she actually has a proper set. Probably one of the only characters I have with the proper set at this point. We got our Black Swan using the Eyes of the Prey, which is pretty decent light cone for her as a free-to-play. Base is pretty close to maxed out. And relics are just pretty random, but it's okay, not too bad. And my Silver Wolf is kind of okay, has a pretty high break effect. Got her own light cone, and I haven't fully maxed out. The plan was to max her out after I get the Acheron, but I haven't got her yet, so that's still in the works. My Kafka is probably the more built character so far. Get close to that 4,000 attack with 155 speed. It's pretty good. Got my Goodnight and Sleep Well. S5 on her, and traces are pretty much maxed, except the normal attack. Relics, it's a pretty good set. Then we got Bronia, which is doing pretty well, plus 200 crit damage. Use Dance 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 on her, don't have her light cone sadly. Traces are kind of lacking, but should get to that. I got the main skills pretty high, which is all that matters. And it's a full like rainbow set too on her. Whatever has a crit for me, I've been putting. And we got the E2, which is awesome. Then I kind of built Argenti, but I don't really like him at all. Got this light cone in S5. Not too bad. I kind of leveled up the traces a little bit just to try him out, but I didn't really like him, so I didn't really build him further. Kind of shitty gear on him. Then we got Sila, which she's pretty built on me too. She's like, she's carried my account for so long because of this light cone you get for free. So she's pretty good. Fully maxed out traces. And just a random rainbow set. I guess this one would be pretty easy to get proper set because I'm only missing boots. Then I got my Jing Liu, which She's kind of built too. She's also good because of the light cone that you get as a free to play, which is awesome. She's pretty much maxed out. And completely rainbow set on her too. I feel like been pretty difficult to get like a set as a free to play. But yeah, when you can't spend any of the jades to use energy to farm relics. I got my Lynx built, but I haven't really used her that much because I mostly use Bailu, so she's decently built, but nothing too special. Then I got my Sampo, which I run a lot on the Black Swan Kafka team. He has like a nearly 4.2k attack. I think I run here like a break effect. Yeah, it's okay. Run this light cone on him. He's also not quite maxed yet, but I don't know if I really like him too much, so that's why I haven't fully invested on his traces, but we'll see. We got Pila, she's a goat. Actually just got her to E6, which is cool. She doesn't have a light cone right now. I was gonna build her back again with the Acheron, but that was basically the plan because she's gonna fit perfectly in an Acheron team. Then we got Yukong. I love Yukong, but she's so hard to play that I kind of bench her after I got the Sparkle because I don't have E6 on her. If I had E6, I would have played her, I think, but for now, she's benched, so that's why her traces are lacking quite a bit. But yeah, I love her as a character. She would be amazing as a Danheng team, but yeah, we can't run her. Asta is really good. 158 speed. This is a good light cone, but that's not that good for her. Just a kind of placeholder. Her traces are pretty high because we got her as an E6. Serval. I used a lot of Serval before I got like Kafka. She was kind of the only lightning DPS, so she's also built pretty decently, but not too much. Got her E6. She also carried me a little bit. And yeah, that's pretty much all the characters I have built so far in like kind of a level 80. Everything else is just lacking pretty hardcore. These ones I mostly leveled because I wanted the Star Rail passes from them, so. And now I've given up kind of leveling the characters. That's why there's a plenty of like level 1 characters here that I haven't leveled up at all. So that's pretty much all my characters so far. Now when it comes to light cones, I do feel like I've been pretty lucky with the light cones, especially the ones that I got S5. Because I did get the Good Night's Sleep while S5, and I also have the Eyes of the Prey, which are both like pretty good for my dot teams. So I've been pretty happy. Obviously we're lacking pretty hard on the 5-star light cones, because they're really hard to roll if you want characters. But yeah, there's not much to go through here on light cones because they are they're not that great, I would say. And I guess the only thing we're gonna go through is my relics. To be honest, I kind of stopped caring about the relics like the set. I've just been trying to roll the specific stats on any of these, so definitely have some decent ones, but a lot of crappy relics. So there's really not much to go through here, but we're gonna speed it up and go through them quickly, so let's go. there we have it. That's pretty much my year one account progression right now. I think I did get pretty lucky with most of the stuff except relics, but the amount of RNG on the relics is ridiculous anyway. It's really hard to get lucky on that. So I did get to the point where I can do all the content anyway, so it doesn't really matter. You don't need perfect relics to play this game. But yeah, it's been pretty fun. 300 hours plus and zero money spent. But you just gotta know when to stop playing the game. And to me, it's now. So I'm really looking forward to playing the other mobile games like the Wuthering Waves and Zenless Zone Zero. Those are like the two games I'm looking forward to right now. But it's been fun. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.